Big thanks to Nathan and Jolene. You know, Nathan and I share a bond. We both won the 100-meter freestyle in the Olympic Games. By the way, the only event that really matters in swimming is the 100-meter freestyle. Just joking. Okay. And to the USA Swimming Foundation, thank you so much for being our host tonight. Okay, to present the next goggles, the award for Breakout Swimmer of the Year. First, an American distance pioneer who is the only American man ever to win the 1500-meter freestyle at back-to-back Olympic Games, a feat he accomplished in 1968 and 1972. There seems to be this distance theme tonight. I'm not sure I like that, being a sprinter. Joining him, a returning friend to the Golden Goggle stage, a longtime star of the screen, known for his roles on Mad About You, Spin City, Argo, and many others. And by the way, he's a good friend of John Ledecky's. We got lots of friends of John Ledecky here. Please welcome three-time Olympic champion Mike Burton and a star of the new Fox hit Gotham, Richard Kind.
Thank you. You know, I've known Mike now for probably most of this evening, hasn't it been? It's been that long.
It's been a long time.
It has been that long. Yeah, and it's a pleasure to stand here next to you because he neglected to tell my swimming records, which I told Mike backstage. First, in freestyle at Green Acres Country Club, Lawrenceville, New Jersey, 1967, and first also, and father-son relay, first place. So.
And Richard, how old were you back then?
I was a little younger than everybody we're going to announce tonight, is how I was very young, and today I'm very, very old. This is for the Breakout Award. Of the year, which is a very ambiguous category, because at what age do you become the breakout? And how do we know that hidden you've won many, many things, which of course they have, and yet now they're all of a sudden they become a breakout. Who announced? I could still be on the Breakout Award.
You could.
I'm low on the list, I'll give you that, but go ahead. Have I said too much?
Well, not all of these nominees are technically rookies to the elite competition, but it's safe to say that they won't be sneaking up on any competitors anymore.
Because in 2014, these five swimmers that we're going to announce secured their status as the future star of Team USA.
First, there's Stanford senior Maya Dorado. She's been an All-American and a member of the World Championship team, but in 2014, she broke through to the top of the podium, claiming gold in the 200 IM at the Pan Pacs and added silver in the 400 IM.
Katie McLaughlin was truly a rookie this year. Her first major international meet, 17-year-old, stroke to bronze in the women's 200 fly at the Pan Pacifics.
And your next breakout performer, Ryan Murphy, was the youngest member of the men's team this year. In 2014, the 19-year-old Cal Bear followed a stunning debut at the NCAA Championships with a bronze in the 100 back at the Pan Pacs, placing him among the absolute elite of the world's backstrokers.
The only person whose last name I had to find out how it was pronounced, Sierra Runge, from the North Baltimore Aquatic Club. In 2014, Runge embraced the distant races and delivered huge drops. At the Pan Pacific, she swam. I'm saying this like I know what I'm talking about.
You're doing great.
I'm gonna find out that. Mike is gonna tell me what a drop is. At the Pan Pacific, she swam to silver in the 400 freestyle for a 1-2 finish for Team USA.
Your final nominee is USC junior Kendall Stewart. This year, the 20-year-old Stewart reached her first major international podium with bronze in the 100 fly and added silver as part of the women's 4x100 medley relay at the Pan Pacs.
I have the great opportunity of trying to say all five names because it was assigned to me. Our nominees are Maya Dorado, Katie McLaughlin, Ryan Murphy, Sierra Runge, and Kendall Stewart. These are your nominees for the 2014 Breakout Swimmer of the Year. I am a guest here. I am so honored to be here that I can't tell you, but a true swimmer will read the winner.
After this video.
Oh.
Dorado improved on her 2013 experience by taking a big step up this summer by capturing two medals at the Pan Pacs, including gold in the 200 IM.
Maya Dorado just powering past the Aussies, and it comes to the touch, and it will be Maya Dorado with a new meet record.
And we're just getting started tonight.
Kate, 17-year-old Katie McLaughlin made the most of her first major international meet by earning the bronze medal in the 200 butterfly at the Pan Pacs.
And Katie McLaughlin slides into the podium position and third.
Just getting started tonight.
Carrying on a rich U.S. backstroke tradition, Ryan Murphy jumped in to win the bronze medal in the 100 back at the Pan Pacs in Australia.
Keep your eyes in the center of the pool. That's where the battle's coming from. As they come into the wall. Ryan Murphy in third.
Just getting started.
A converted sprinter, Sierra Runge's move to distance swimming took a major step forward in 2014 as she won the silver medal in the 400 freestyle at Pan Pacs.
At the wall it will be. Sierra Runge finishes in second place.
Girl, the crazy thing is we're just getting warmed up.
Stewart won the 50 and 100 butterfly at the Nationals in Irvine before moving on to Pan Pacs, where she won the bronze medal in the 100 fly and a silver on the medley relay.
Kendall Stewart's hanging in there.
Kendall Stewart, lane number six. Can she get it done here? 5 meters to go. Stewart holds on for third.
And we're just getting started tonight.
Mike, who is the winner of the Breakout Award in 2014?
Okay, the winner is Maya Dorado.
First things first, I'm the realist.
A true surprise, and I don't have my shoes on, so I'm sorry about that. You know, it's weird to be a post-college breakout swimmer of the year, but I think that just speaks to how well USA Swimming takes care of their athletes and continually encourages them to always keep going, and you know, you can do it, and you'll get there someday. And so I'm just really thankful for USA Swimming and all the coaches on the staff and the USA Swimming Foundation and this incredible event. And it's so fun to see all of these fans of the sport, as well as my friends and teammates. And I'd like to thank my coaches, who have also been so patient with me and helped me get here today. And so this is incredible, and I just want to thank you all so much for this.